Welcome back. So I had a good time up at Oshkosh, and this is actually in the evening, relaxing with a bunch of pilots and just hanging out at one of the local beer tents there. And this is actually the place where I came up with the idea for building the Raptor 5 years ago, almost to the day that I was there. So a bit of nostalgia there for you. Anyway, a good time was had, and learned a lot of things that are going to help the project going forward. But nothing that I can really talk about right now. Anyway, you'll hear more about it later on as things progress. But back to reality, and while you look at the spar there for the foreplane, it's been released and trimmed, I'll give you what's going on with the bad news. So Jim has decided to move on, so he's given us 2 weeks' notice. He's off to a new project down in Florida. And Zach has also decided to move on, so it's unfortunate. He's been with us for over 2 years, so we'll definitely miss him. So we're actually going to be down to three of us once the college kids go. So I'm actually looking to see if we can find someone else to fill maybe at least Jim's position. Someone who's knowledgeable and wants to sort of, you know, Airbnb it for a couple of months and just help us out. Someone who has good skills with their hands. Anyway, if you know of anybody, but... Meanwhile, onto this. So I was working this on Monday, starting to put in the radius blocking here for the inside parts of the fuselage, and anywhere where there's kind of like a right angle, we need to put in a setup of resin and micro in order to sort of make a sort of like a fillet smooth thing. And then we're going to be doing a layup over that, and that's going to help with the pressurization. And meanwhile, Jeff and Devin have been laying up the ribs for the foreplane and the elevator, so there's a few of them there under vacuum. So they actually made quite a lot of progress already. I think they're more than halfway through all those 30 that were needed to be done. And this is what it looks like with some of the ones that have already been done now sitting in that spar, just sort of test fit there. They're not bonded in or anything, just to show how that's going to lay out. And so that's coming along. And here's Keith working on getting some of the core pieces done for the some more of those ribs there for the elevator and the foreplane. So there's only a handful left to do there, as you can see. And just when you thought the doors were all done, actually while I was away, came back and have noticed there that the hinge pins on this door here were locking up on one side, like they got some dirt or something in them, and so they weren't... It got kind of messed up. So I actually had to cut out the sleeve, as you'll see here, with the Dremel. The other one just actually fell out. It wasn't fully bonded in yet. It was just 5 minutes in. But anyway, I had to cut that sleeve out in order to get this out. And that pin there was literally jammed in there. So we're actually going to, you know, make some new sleeves like that. And I'm not sure if it was some dust or whatever got in there, but basically those pins locked up, and when they locked up, the sleeve started rotating in the door hinge pocket, and so the only way to get it out was to cut it out. Anyway, you know, stressful when you have problems like that. So next thing here is these are the adjusters there for the flow for the gear, and Jim has been busy there today, and he's got those prepped up. We're just waiting on the right size fittings. Will come in tomorrow, and we can get those in, and then hopefully get the gear working smoothly up and down. And meanwhile, I got this other door back on now, and which it was on the other day, but after we put the skin on, it wasn't closing all the way, and I think it's just a bit of curvature or something like that where it had flattened out while it was off. But anyway, making progress on getting it snugged in there. And then back on the inside there, here's all that resin and micro mix that I've been putting in there, the radius. So that's going to get a quick sanding tomorrow and fill any other little holes or bits that I missed there, and then we'll be able to get ready to lay that up. And this is something that is a bit of a pain that we have to do, and I need to figure out a way to not have to do this for production. We may have to change some of the molds to, like, you know, put the radius on the actual parts here as well, so we don't have to do this radius blocking after the fact. It's just time consuming. And now that the foreplane spars are done and the ribs are almost done as well, time to pull out the molds here for the wing spars. And these are the last of the spars, basically, last of almost everything, really. And so this is the left-hand side one, and Jeff's been cutting templates and that for the core for that. And meanwhile, finishing off on some more of these ribs there for the foreplane and elevator. and there's the last ones there that are ready to lay up tomorrow with the fabric already, or the carbon already cut for those. And our new heavier gas struts for the doors arrive, so we'll be able to put those on in the coming days and see how they work. And while I was up at Oshkosh, someone pointed out to me that my intercooler positioning wasn't going to work very well for a couple of different reasons, so I had to think of a different layout. And I got it all sorted out, and I actually ordered all the parts while I was up there, so there's a bunch of pipes and stuff that I need. And there's the water-air intercooler they're going to be using, so that's going to come after the air-to-air intercooler that we have right now. And you see there's the water feed in there, which will actually be a fuel feed. And then this is where the air comes in and out. So that hopefully will do the trick and get us some cooler temps going into the engine and lower the EGTs, and at the same time give us some more horsepower. So I just got to find the time now to get that sorted out with everything else that I'm trying to do. And again, if you know of anybody who may want to come and help us out for a couple of months, please let me know in the comments or email me or something. And that's our video for the start of this week, and thanks again for watching.